What is the difference between stony and soft corals? Corals are corals are corals, right? Kinda. Some corals have a hard skeleton while others don't, and that is the main difference between hard stony corals and soft corals. But sometimes the lines get a bit blurred because even stony corals can appear to be soft and fleshy. So let's take a good look at what makes a stony coral stony. Ultimately, what it comes down to is if the coral has a hard skeleton. If the coral does have a calcium carbonate skeleton that the polyps protrude from, it's considered a stony coral, even if that polyp is large and fleshy and sways back and forth. For example, SPS or small polyp stony corals have tiny polyps protruding out of their hard skeleton, so they don't really move or sway and they don't appear very fleshy. Meanwhile, LPS or large polyp stony corals still have a hard skeletal base that their larger fleshy polyps protrude from, and because they can be so large and fleshy, they might appear to be soft and easily sway back and forth in the flow, but because they still protrude out of a hard calcium carbonate skeleton, they are considered to be a stony coral. If that coral were to perish and the fleshy polyps melted away, you'd still have a hard skeleton left behind. Soft corals, on the other hand, do not have a hard skeleton. Instead, their soft, fleshy bodies are filled with small spear-shaped spicules made from calcium carbonate that help to add rigidity to their soft, fleshy bodies while they're expanded. If that coral were to perish and melted away, there would be no skeleton left behind, and while you might find a few tiny spicules here and there, chances are there'd be no trace the coral was ever there at all. The only real exception to that rule, which I did hint at earlier, would be gorgonians and sea fans that do leave behind a sort of flexible skeleton. But unlike the hard and rigid calcium carbonate skeletons of stony corals, their skeletons are usually dark brown or black, super thin, and very bendy. So the next big question, is there a difference in stony and soft coral care in a reef tank? Yes, there absolutely is a difference. And when it comes to caring for corals in a reef tank, stony corals tend to be more demanding than soft corals, especially for those who are newer to the hobby. Because they don't have a true skeleton, soft corals tend to be much less demanding of alkalinity and calcium. Soft corals also tend to come from nutrient-rich environments that are silty and murky, so many soft corals have no problem in a reef aquarium that has high nutrients and isn't dosed very often. In other words, they are very hardy and usually do just fine in an aquarium with less than ideal conditions for stony corals. They're also typically less demanding of intense lighting as well, so you can easily keep them without getting high-end light fixtures. With that being said, having a good reef light is going to have a pretty large impact on how colorful many of those soft corals will be. LPS, or large polyp stony corals, are a great place to start for reefers that want to get into stony corals. While they will definitely require you to test your aquarium at least weekly and dose additives to maintain the levels of two major elements, alkalinity and calcium, many LPS do appreciate higher nutrients, just like soft corals, and do just fine with similar light conditions. LPS, however, can also benefit quite a lot from proper flow, so making sure you have a capable wave pump or pumps is also going to be important. Now, SPS, or small polyp stony corals, are considered to be the most difficult corals to keep. They are the most sensitive to water parameters, require stable conditions with optimal levels of not only the major elements, but also minor and trace elements. Many of them, especially Acropora, require pristine water with just the right level of nutrients in order to thrive and look their best. They typically require the most intense lighting, along with the most intense and thoughtfully implemented flow. An aquarium designed for SPS corals is going to be the most challenging and often the most costly in equipment and additives. If a soft coral reef is mini punt, an SPS reef is the peak of professional golf. If a soft coral reef is go-karting, an SPS reef is Formula One. If a soft coral reef is, I'm sure you've got the idea. But what about mixed reef tanks? Mixed reefs are the ones that have a little bit of everything, softies, LPS, and SPS. They are actually the toughest reef tanks to keep happy because you're trying to delicately balance the needs of all three types of corals in a single environment. It is a serious challenge and one that I've taken on many, many times. It can be really rewarding and also seriously frustrating. So, in my humble opinion, a mixed reef is truly the toughest reef to keep. And for those of you who beg to differ, feel free to get in the comments and change my mind. Mind you, if you're here to learn the real difference between soft corals and stony corals, then chances are you're setting up your first reef, and there's no better place to start that journey than our 5-minute guide series, especially the episode on the top 10 best beginner corals, which you can check out right here.